In this video, we'll take a look at how to enter questionnaire or survey data into SPSS. And this is something that a lot of people have questions with, so it's important to make sure when you're working with SPSS, in particular, when you're entering data from a survey, that you know how to do. So let's go ahead and take a few moments to look at that. And here you see on the right-hand side of your screen, I have a questionnaire, a very short sample questionnaire that I want to enter into SPSS. So we're going to create a data file. And in this questionnaire here, I've made a few modifications. I've underlined some variable names here, and I'll talk about that more in a minute. And I also put numbers in parentheses to the right of these different names. And I'll also explain that as well. Now, normally when someone sees this survey, we wouldn't have gender underlined, for example, nor would we have these numbers to the right of male and female. So that's just for us to help better understand how to enter these data. So let's go ahead and get started here. In SPSS, the first thing we need to do is, every time we have a possible answer, such as male or female, we need to create a variable in SPSS that will hold those different answers. So our first variable needs to be gender, and that's why that's underlined there, just to assist us as we're doing this. So we want to make sure we're in the variable view tab, and then in the first row here under name, we want to type gender and then press enter, and that creates the variable gender. Now notice here I have two options, male and female. So when people respond or circle or check here that they're a male, I need to enter into SPSS some number to indicate that. So we always want to enter numbers whenever possible in SPSS, because SPSS, for the vast majority of analyses, performs statistical analyses on numbers, not on words. So I wouldn't want to enter male, female, and so forth. I want to enter ones, twos, and so on. So notice here, I just arbitrarily decided males get a 1 and females get a 2. It could have been the other way around, but since male was the first name listed, I went ahead and gave that a 1, and then for females I gave a 2. So what we want to do in our data file here is go ahead and go to values, this column, click on the none cell. Notice these three dots appear. They're called an ellipsis. Click on that. And then our first value, notice here, 1 is male. So value of 1, and then type label male, and then click add. And then our second value of 2 is for females. So go ahead and enter 2 for value, and then female, click add. And then we're done with that. You want to see both of them down here, and that looks good. So click OK. Now those labels are in here, and I'll show you how that works when we enter some numbers in a minute. Okay, next we have ethnicity, so I'm going to call this variable ethnicity. So go ahead and type that in, press enter, and then we're going to do the same thing. We're going to create value labels here. So 1 is African American, 2 is Asian American, and so on. And I'll just do that very quickly. So going to values column, click on that ellipsis. For 1, we have African American. For 2, Asian American. 3 is Caucasian. And just so you can see that here, 3 is Caucasian, 4 is Hispanic, and other is 5. So let's go ahead and finish that. 4 is Hispanic. 5 is other. So let's go ahead and do that. 5 is other. Okay, and that's it for that variable. Now we do have, it says please state. I'll talk about that next. That's important when they can enter text. We have to handle that differently.